Today I'm going to show you my best kept secret when it comes to designing rave flyers. What's going on everyone, my name is Tom from Dreadlabs and I'm a graphic designer and visual artist. And if you know me and my channel, you know that I enjoy designing rave flyers the most. Throughout the years, I might have designed hundreds of rave flyers, and in that time, I found a lot of different assets that I found useful in order to design those flyers. The thing is, however, assets can become expensive. So what I did was I created a pack that contains everything you need in order to design rave flyers, all in one pack. Today I want to give you a demonstration of that pack. Before you click away, I don't want you to buy this product if you don't want it. Of course, by doing so, you would support my channel. But the meaning of this video is to give you some inspiration when it comes to designing rave flyers or anything like that. So although this video will be a demonstration of how easy it is to use this pack when it comes to designing rave flyers, this video can still give you enough inspiration even if you don't want to buy anything advertised in this video. Without any further ado, let's get into designing. So we're gonna make a new print file of an A4. We're gonna create a solid color. Let's go with a bright green. We can delete the background. Let's add in an illustration. Let's do a textured one. Scale this guy up. Let's add in some shapes. Add in the date and the location. Let's open up the smiley builder. Let's go with this guy. We'll copy it into Photoshop and we'll have the artist names. I couldn't think of any artists, so I just added headliner and artist A through artist D. All right, so next we're gonna group all of this into a single folder. So all the contents besides the background color. We'll turn this into a smart object and we'll run the ink bleed with the rough edges effect that's also part of the pack. And now if we zoom in here, we'll get a beautiful ink bleed effect. Let's finish that off with a displacement map, which as you can see adds even more detail. And we'll top that off with a couple of paper textures. And here we are. So creating this flyer only took about a couple of minutes. Obviously when you want to fine tune this, it will probably take a little more time, but for now I just wanted to demonstrate a couple of elements of this pack. So like I said earlier in the video, one of my concerns lately is the budget of designers nowadays, because I think it's pretty much worldwide where the cost of living is going up. And because of this, I know that probably a lot of you out there aren't able to afford their asset packs anymore. So to kind of like counter that, I wanted to do two things. First, I want to give away this PSD flyer for you for free. So you can use this template and, you know, play around with this single displacement map and the shapes that I used in this pack, just as a thank you for all the support of the past few years. And to give you guys an idea on what this asset pack does, of course. But also, if you want to get this pack for real, I actually have three versions: light, standard, and pro. So the Photoshop actions are included in the light version, as well as 5 textures, 20 of the shapes that I just showed you in this demo. And then in the standard pack, which is 10 bucks, you'll also get 3 flyer mockups, 52 vector shapes, 10 textures instead of 5, 5 of the displacement maps that I just showed you. And the pro version includes 3 Photoshop actions, 25 textures, 84 vector shapes, 10 displacement maps, and even 12 hand-drawn illustrations, such as the one that you saw in the demo just now. The price of the pro version is 20 bucks and it comes with 139 assets, and all of the versions, so including the light version and standard version, they all have the smiley builder inside. And the smiley builder lets you build over 1000 different smileys. So if you want to add those up, you'll have over 1000 assets in all of these 3 packs, starting from 5 euros. I also wanted to do the first demo in Photoshop because I know a lot of you out there don't use Illustrator. And I just want to clarify that all of these shapes in this pack, even the smiley builder, are also available if you don't use Photoshop. They work faster if you use Illustrator, but this complete pack is also compatible with Photoshop and pretty much any design software, with the only exception being Photoshop Actions as well as the PSD files for the mockups. So I'm gonna do a couple of more demos, and these demos will be available on my Patreon channel as well. So let's dive into the next one. So we'll do another A4 flyer, but let's go with an Illustrator file next, and let's open the bonus shapes. As you can see, these are the additional shapes that are included in the pack. The top half is included with the standard version, and everything that you can see here is included in the pro version. So let's paste this guy in, add in some text, head into the smiley builder, and I think it would be coolest if we grab the Murakami style smiley. And we can either add a meta ball or the vibrations. And I think the vibrations would be cool here. So outline everything and flatten it. Scale it down. Let's grab the original 20 shapes. I think this one would fit in nicely. And let's see if we have a nice friendly font at the bottom here. Let's top off the flyer with something along the edges here. Not sure what yet. Maybe these small flowers. All right, let's bring this into Photoshop. Add a nice vibrant like tomato red, I think. I will drop in our design. And I think what would be nice here is if we add the stamp ink bleed. As you can see, we do have like some outlines here, but the effect is much softer, and this also adds some subtle grain here and there, which I kind of do like. What could be fun is if we add in some color. Let's see what would happen there. A little bit vibrant, but we can make it work. Let's add in some textures. And there's number two. So now that we finished our second flyer, I just want to quickly say that all of the Rave flyers from this video are available on my Patreon channel. So from the second flyer onward, all of the Photoshop files and Illustrator files are available on my Patreon channel through the link down below. By becoming a patron, you'll also get a 15% discount in my asset web store, which gives you a 15% discount on the Rave flyer essentials as well. Since this video is already kind of promoting towards my asset pack, I don't want to bore you with another segment about my Patreon channel. The only thing I want to say about it is if you don't have the budget to become a patron yourself, that's fine. You can always subscribe for a month and unsubscribe at any time. This will give you access to everything in one go. The only downside is that you will miss out on future PSD files and stuff. And of course, if you don't have any budget at all, leaving a like and a comment for the algorithm will do wonders for me, because you started commenting and liking my videos more often lately, and that really does help my channel out. And of course, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that already, because some of you might think you're subscribed, but you actually aren't. Without any further ado, let's get into the third flyer. All right, let's go for a square one for a change. And I want to start out with one of the illustrations, a little eye monster. You might remember this guy from my Creatober challenge, where I made this guy in 3D and I decided to grab a marker and trace this guy to make an illustration out of him for this pack. Let's add some text. All right, we'll create some outline around our beast here. Let's add in this shape here. We'll add in some detail. Let's just grab this and put it into Photoshop, and let's go with a nice Dreadlabs green. And instead of going for an ink bleed, I just want to go straight into a displacement map. We'll use the add noise slash grain. I just instantly added some grain into our design here, as you can see. I do like that. So another thing that I want to go and do is add a little bit of depth to this. And what I'm going to do is duplicate the design, go to filter, blur, box blur, and we'll do maybe 3 pixels, maybe a little bit higher, 6. But then we'll lower the opacity of the box blur by 50%. And as you can see, this adds a nice little shadow to our design without it being too out there, if that makes sense. So there we have it, number 3. I will do the last one in Photoshop. So let's make a new one, we'll do an A4, and let's start out with another illustration again, and we'll do one with the eye here. Fun fact, people might hate me when I say this, but this was actually done with a calligraphy pen. Don't be mad at me, I just like the effect that it had. Let's grab this one, kind of like, looks like lightning or tribal things. I'm gonna group this and make sure that all of these are black, all of the shapes that I will drop in. Actually, what might be cool is if we remove the fill and add a stroke, so that it's an outline shape. And we'll mask out the contents where the eye is. What else can we put in here? Maybe this one. Let's go to the discs and dartboards one and add in one more. Maybe the vibration kind of icon. And this is really looking hypnotizing. I really like that. I'll just make the color here a solid purple or something like that. Looks pretty cool. So putting this behind our text makes our text a little bit more legible. All right, I'm not sure about this green here, so I think I'm just gonna go back and fix that a little bit. Like this. All right, let's grab the full design, turn it into a smart object, and we'll add in some displacement map, and we'll add the noise and grain and finish it off with a couple of textures. All right, there we have it. 4 flyers that I easily made using the Dreadlabs Rave Flyer Essentials. I hope this video gave you enough ideas to start creating Rave Flyers on your own, and perhaps you even consider buying the asset pack, whether it's the light, standard, or the pro version. If you really don't want to get into designing yourself, but you want to use one of the flyers that I made in this video as a template, of course you can, because like I said earlier in the video, all of the Illustrator and Photoshop files from this video are available on my Patreon page. If you want to become a patron, or if you want to get the asset pack, both of those will be linked down in the description. With all of that being said, this is Tom from Dreadlabs tuning out. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.